Hello my friend, today we want to work with Shopify, we want to extract all the products from the shop. Yeah, we want to explore the data, we want to do some pre-processing steps, get the images, clean up the description, and then also want to create a vector store. What we can do in the end, the user could search, for example, I want an Adidas shoe for my child, and here are the recommendations, Adidas shoes. We also have other shoes from Nike and Converse, because in the database we don't have a lot of data, so we have actually only four Adidas products and only two are for kids. Therefore, the vector store realized, okay, the other Adidas products are not for kids. So here we will recommend them another product for kids. Also, in this case, are Nike and Converse. And we have saved the images and could also show the user the images of the products. That's amazing, isn't it? In this video, as I said, you will learn how to do this. In the next video, we want to deploy it and integrate it in something like BotPress. So I hope you're excited, because this is really good and you're going to learn a lot. Have fun watching. Okay, what we first want to do, we want to head over to shopify.dev and sign up, create a new account and get some sample data and then explore that. Okay, we created our Shopify store. This is what we want to do. We want to go to add apps and Shopify app store, and then we want to get the simple sample data. I have access to a real Shopify account, but I don't want to work with their data here in the video, obviously. So we're going to work with the sample data. Okay, click install app. Yeah, just have flows data, take everything. Right now we just want to work with products, but we still want to generate everything else. That's fine. Let's make a directory for our code. Shop Langchain testing, I don't know, something like this. Shopify CD into it. Let's open up VS Code terminal. What we want here, we obviously need the .env file. We need the requirements. We want a Jupyter notebook file. Okay, and let us also create a new virtual environment, which is the virtual environment command, and we call it Langchain. Now click on yes. So this environment will be for this, will be loaded every time we are in the, we're in this folder and this workspace. Okay, so the requirements we are going to need are Langchain, Panda, Python.env, Tick token, JQ, contents, transformers, Beautiful Soup 4, FISS CPU, Fast API, and UV Core. Let's install it. Okay. Here we want to select the Langchain Shopify. We want to get all the products. So here in the API documentation under products, we get on a retrieve a list of products and can click on retrieve all products. And here is how the request has to look. So the thing here is the sample data is very small, 30 elements. When you would request the data in real shop, then you would have to account for the API limits. So here you can only make, I think, 40 requests per minute. So I will define a function for that. Okay, let's add the Shopify API key here and also the OpenAI key. We will need both. Perfect. Now, okay, we need the shop URL, which will be Langchain testing. So HTTPS, and the API version from July 2023. And define the function get all products. That's it, okay. Shopify access token, no. Shopify API key. And we also need the parameters. Set the limit to 250, that's the maximum. Params equals params, okay. We also want to define the list with all products. We want to extend the list with product elements in the response. So, and here is the thing, with the response you would get the links field with the next link because of the API limit. And then you would just call all the next links. All what we also want to add here, we want to import time. Time.sleep 2 seconds. And you want to accept a key error in the case that links is empty. In that case, we want to just return all products since we already have all products. Yeah, basically, that's it. That might not be the best solution, but it works. It accounts for the API limit, the time.sleep. You only make one request every 2 seconds, so 30 per minute. That's sufficient. And here we want to give in the shop URL and the API version. Okay, so, all products, get all products. Okay, the data has been generated. Now, what we have to do is go on apps again, app and channel settings, and then develop apps. Okay, now allow custom app development. Yes, allow it. Create an app. The app will be Langchain. We just call it the same as we called the store itself. There we get the API key. So yeah, configure the admin scopes. We will right now just configure it to get everything that has something to do with the product data, write product feeds, read product feeds, listings, and write and read products. That's enough. So we can work here also with customer data, with orders and everything, but right now we just want to work with the data for the products. Okay, install the access token app. Okay, and then get the admin key. Obviously you should not show this to anyone, but I will delete it later, so it's okay. And now we add it here in the .env. Now we should be able to request our data. Let's test it out. Oh, okay, there's an error. Ah, okay, that's our domain right now.
0.3.4.99.
And there we have all our products. Okay, now there are a couple of things we want to do. Let's get the first product and we want to see what keys are there. We have the ID, title, body HTML, which is a description, status. So now we have to do some exploration, some pre-processing. What I want to do at first is import pandas SPD and put it into a pandas data frame. Now we can look at status, for example. So dot status value count. Okay, we have 30 active elements. So there might be some cases where you have other statuses, for example, draft, archive, and you have to account for that. So you have to filter out all the elements that are not active, and we are going to do that in a little bit. Next thing, we want to check the body HTML, how the elements here are looking. Okay, this looks fine. There are no HTML tags, but for the case that there would be some HTML tags, you would have to also write a function to account for that. And another thing, we want to see which fields are not filled, so there's no element in it. For example, here in template suffix is nothing. We see in body HTML, okay, every element here has something. The title everywhere filled. Let's see, the tags are filled everywhere. Okay, perfect. But there might be cases where some fields are not filled. So what you could do, fill NA, just fill it with a string that's empty, so that there is at least a string in it. Because if there's nothing in it, you might encounter errors if you work with it. So therefore, you want to at least have an empty string. Okay, I want to define a couple of functions to pre-process and work with the data. What we have done here, we have looked at a little bit at the data, we have explored it, we have seen, okay, where are the values that are not available, how does the description look. This is the data exploration. You have to find out what you're working with, so you know where you have to clean it up and refine it a little bit. We have here mostly no problems. The sample data are really good, but I still want to define the functions for the pre-processing. We can define lambda row, for example, and apply a function to each single row. And here I would, for example, have the function clean HTML tags, and I would enter row. And we also have to define axis 1. If we don't define axis 1, it would take the columns, but we want to work with the rows. Okay, now we have to obviously define the clean HTML function and clean HTML text, so we get the row. We want to define the beautiful soup. Yeah, get the body HTML entry from the row, call the HTML parser and extract the text with get tag to assign the text again to the row and return the row. Every element here would be cleaned up in this data frame. So we will also have to MPS4 and beautiful soap. Okay, now let's look at how the field images works or is defined. Let's call it product data frame. Product data frame dot images. We want to pd dot set option display max column width to 1000, for example. Okay, now we can see all the elements. Okay, as we see here, we have each row has a list with JSON elements, and every JSON element is one image which has a source that's the link to the image. We can also click the link and we see an image. Okay, that's perfect. We want to extract all those links, so define another function which we can apply. So define image source from a row for every image in row images. We also define all images list images dot append image source. Okay, and then we want to create a new field images list, assign all images to it, and then return the row. Okay, there's one other function we want to define. Product data frame dot head gets us the top 5 elements of the data frame. We want to create an embedding database, and my idea was we don't just want to only have the description in the embedding, but we also want to add the title, the description, and the tags. For example, if you look at the description here, I don't see Adidas mentioned in here, and therefore we will also want the title and the text, because let's say a customer wants a product recommendation from me. He says, yeah, I want Adidas shoe for my son. And then we, since we have added the tags, we see, oh, okay, this product is from Adidas, it's for kids. Yeah, Stan Smith, that's a shoe, I think. Yeah, it's a shoe, kids shoes. So we have all the elements here in one field. And therefore, we want to create this field, which then is going to be turned into embedding. These are some thought processes you have to put into this whole thing, because if you would only have the description embedded, might not account the Adidas part in this case. So therefore, the results might be worse. So these are things you have to account for. Think about it, what you want to do, what elements you want to combine, how should your database look at the end. And therefore, we want to define a new function, create expanded description field. We take the row into it. In our case, we explored the data and everything is fine. All fields are filled, but let's say if you wouldn't have a description at one product, or you wouldn't have tags for one product, this might happen in a store. Therefore, you have to work with that and filter it out. Now, we want to define the data frame preprocessing. So we input the data frame. We want to filter out all elements that are not active. So we would do data frame equals to data frame from data where status equals active. So now we would have filtered out all elements that are not active. The next thing you would want to do, data frame dot fill an A with an empty string in place true. So without in place true, we would have to assign it again, but in this case, we just do it in place. Now data frame equals data frame dot apply lambda row. We can make get image source, and we can apply create expand description and also the clean HTML text. We want to rename the column body HTML dot rename columns and write the body HTML to description. And the last thing, we want to filter out the columns. We want specifically the ID, title, description, expanded description which we created, images list. Okay, return the data frame. Cleaned data frame will be the... Okay, we obviously have to run this, and then we can also just copy the functions over. Let's look at the cleaned data frame, and there we have it. The ID, the title, the description, the expanded description, the tags, perfect, and the image list. Okay, we want to do two things here. First, we want to save the data frame as a CSV file, products.csv, ignore the index, and we want to turn it into a JSON file. So clean data frame to JSON. We want to orient it to records. That's important here. So every row will be one JSON element, and then we want to write it with open products.json file write clean products.json. Okay, so now we have saved it. Here are the JSON products. Here's the CSV file. Perfect. Now we're almost ready to create a vector store. We want to create documents. We want to work with the Langchain JSON loader and load the JSON. So let's get this first. From Langchain document loads JSON, import JSON loader. Yeah, we can define a metadata and the content key, which will be our expanded description. We'll add the images to the metadata and the ID, obviously. If you will recommend the product, we know the ID of it and get it from the store, maybe provide a link to the user, show him the images and the JQ schema. You can look it up, it's a little bit complicated, but how we saved it, we can simply run dot in the brackets, so you can easily load it. Let's just actually go to the Langchain site for a JSON loader. There I have a good documentation here. Get the metadata function. Okay, we want to define metadata from ID, title, text, image description. Now we want to load it. The name is products.json. Here again, the JQ schema, basically dot and the brackets. The content key will be our expanded description and the metadata function. Okay, now we want to load it, call it documents. Okay, now let's go to creating the vector store part. Define a new file, create vector store. We need a document loading here. Here we'll have our documents. Embeddings will be the OpenAI embeddings. Create a definition, create vector store. So this will basically be the same from my last tutorial. You probably have seen it. Index 50 PDF books in 5 minutes. Vector store equals FISS dot from document. Documents equals documents and equals embeddings. So, and we input here the documents and embedding. Return the vector. Okay, and we also need the save vector store. We get the vector store path and the index. index name vectors. Yeah, save path and index name. Okay. We also want to print vector source save to save path. Now we want to call if main visit name equals main. So put this into it. And the save path, we want to call it Shopify Langchain testing vector store. Beautifully long name. Now we can call it -3 create vector store. Obviously, get the API key. Okay, now with the API key, create vector store. This should be very fast. Okay, now I want to define utils.py, and here we want to define a load vector store, vector store path, index name, load local, and also want to give it the embeddings, which will be the OpenAI embeddings, and return the vector store. We want to also name the parameters. We can now test it out. Utils import load vector store. And vector store will be vector store load index name products, and now we can load it and result. Let's test it. Vector store dot similarity search. I want Adidas shoe for my child. Okay, for product in result, print product dot page content. And there we have it. Adidas, oh, something from Nike and Converse. Damn, not perfect. Not perfect. We actually have 4 Adidas. Okay, let's see. Ah, okay, that's interesting. We said for our kit, and we have here 4 Adidas products, but one is a woman backpack. Two are backpack. And here are the 2 things which apply for kits, it seems. Therefore, the results actually aren't that bad. So it also returned from Nike. Is it also for kids? Yeah, also for kids. Okay, so actually it worked really good. We did it. Let's... print product metadata images list. Okay, and we can also look at the images and recommend it to the user.
Click the like button, click the subscribe button, and see you in the next video.